main objective of this program to explain what is a linked list, how it can be created, what is a self-referencing structure, etc. If you verify the program, we have defined a structure LST which contains a integer number n as a data member, and also struct LST star next, that is a structured pointer variable of type LST, that is next, as a data member of this structure. We have defined three structured variables A, B, C and a structured pointer variable, LST type of structured pointer variable H. H value is uninitialized initially. You can verify the adjacent table, the memory cell numbers, of course assumptions of these A, B, C structured variables, and we have denoted two elements of each structure with the two cells just for the sake of understanding purpose. Now if we execute a dot n is equal to 10, then the value 10 will be stored in the data member n of the structured variable a, which is shown in the figure. Now b dot n is equal to 27, instruction will be executed. Thus the number 27 will be stored in the data member n of the structured variable b. The same will be displayed in the table. Now c dot n is equal to 30, instruction is executed. Thus value 30 is stored in the data member n of the structured variable c. We can verify the table. Now the instruction a dot next is equal to ampersand b will be executed. That is, the address of the structured variable b is assigned to a dot next, that is data member next of the structured variable a. Thus a dot next becomes a pointer to the structured variable b. Thus the address of b, that is 20432, is assigned to a dot next. The same we can verify in the figure. Now the instruction b dot next is equal to ampersand c will be executed. That is, the address of the structured variable c, that is 20322, is assigned to next data member of the structured variable b. That is, b dot next becomes 20322. We can verify the same thing in the figure. Now the instruction c dot next is equal to 0 is executed. That is, 0 will be assigned to c dot next. You have to remember one important aspect. We cannot assign arbitrary memory cell numbers to any pointer variable. However, the exception is for 0. Thus c dot next is equal to 0 is a acceptable statement. Now h is equal to ampersand a will be executed. That is, the address of the structured variable a, that is 20686, will be now assigned to h. Thus h becomes pointer to a. If you verify, you can find the address of the structured variable c is available in b dot next, then the address of the structured variable b is available in a dot next, and whereas the address of a is available in h. H is normally called as the head of the linked list. This type of structure, that is, the address of one node is available in the previous node and the address of that one is available in the previous node of it, vice versa, it is called as a linked list. Just for the purpose of demonstration, we have shown the links with arrows. that is B dot next is now pointing to C, arrow is drawn. Similarly, A dot next is equal to is pointing to B, thus another arrow is drawn, and now H is pointing to A, thus another arrow is drawn from H to A. Now we wanted to explain how we can traverse the linked list from the topmost node, that is the head of the linked list, to the bottommost node and print all the contents of the each node. The following while loop will explain how the same can be carried out. First, while H condition is evaluated, what is the current value of H? That is 20686. Is it positive? Yes. Positive means is it true? Yes. Thus, the while condition is true, we will enter into the loop. Now the printf statement, that is a printf percentage d h arrow n will be executed. Currently, H is pointing to the structured variable A. H arrow n refers to the data member n of the structured variable A as H is pointing to A. Thus, this printf statement will give us value 10 on the screen. Now the instruction H is equal to H arrow next will be executed. What is the H arrow next value? H is currently pointing to A. So, HRIN is 10, whereas HRN next is 20432. Thus, 20432 is assigned to H. Thus, H now becomes pointer to the B. H is no longer pointer to the A. You can see the same. H is now pointing to the structured variable B, because H value is now 20432. Now, again, while H condition is evaluated, currently H value is 20432, it is a positive, which means it is true, thus, again, we will be entering into the loop. Now, the printf statement HRIN is executed, that is, we are asking to print HRIN. Currently, H is pointing to the structured variable B. Thus, HRIN means we are referring to the data member N of the structured variable B. Now, if you verify in the figure, that is 27. So, this printf statement will print 27. Now, the statement H is equal to HRN next will be executed again. What is the current value of H? It is nothing but the address of the structured variable B. H is pointing to B. HRIN, already we understood 27, that has been printed in the previous printf statement. Now, what is HRIN next? That is 20322. What is 20322? That is the address of the structure variable C. Thus, when you say H is equal to HRIN next, then the 20322 will be assigned to the H. That indicates that H now points to the structured variable C. H no longer will point to the structured variable B. Now onwards, H is a pointer to C. Now again, the while condition is tested. While H, H is 20322, which is a positive number. Thus, the while condition is true. Thus, loop will be executed once more. Now the printf statement, printf percentage the HRIN will be executed. Currently, H is pointing to the structured variable C. HRIN refers to the data member N of the structured variable C. Thus, HRIN means 30. That will be printed because of this printf statement. Now, the statement H is equal to HRIN next will be executed. What is HRIN? That is 30. As H is pointing to the structured variable C, HRIN refers to the data member N of the structured variable C. In the same fashion, HRIN next refers to the data member next of the structured variable C, which is now 0. Thus, 0 will be assigned to H. As of now, H points to the C, but now when H becomes 0, H is not at all pointing to any object. Now again while condition is executed, that is while h, currently h value is 0, so 0 means false, thus we will be coming out from the while loop. Thus we have started from the root node, that is a, then we have printed the data member of a, that is n, 10, then again the h came down to the b, then hrn, that is 27, there is nothing but b dot n will be printed, and then again h came to another next node, that is c, then c dot n, that is 30, is printed. Like that we have traversed from the topmost node of the linked list to till the bottommost node, and we have manipulated, or rather I say we have simply printed the data members of each node. Really we can do any other operation, instead of only simply printing we can do some other operations also on these nodes, and this is called as a traversal of the linked list.